My nerves would always come as we're producing a batch today, this week. Are we going to be successful in producing the vaccine and delivering it on the timelines that they need it? That's my part of the mission, part of the job. As the outbreak became worse and worse and the news became worse, we really ramped up the program as fast as we could. My name is Dick Schwartz. I'm the chief of the vaccine production program at the Vaccine Research Center and at the NIH. We have the ability to rapidly translate research into clinical products. So we've done plasma DNAs for HIV, for flu, SARS. Because we had done one for West Nile virus, which is a related flavivirus, when Zika came up, we said, oh, it's a flavivirus, this may work. If this was a virus that, say, the VRC had no experience with prior, it would be highly unlikely that we would be able to go from concept into a clinical product anywhere near as quick.
Just pre-harvest, 120-ish,
about 115, 110, 120.
We started up a team to start development into research probably 6 or 8 months ago. Because it's an outbreak situation, we are maybe doing a few less experiments than we like, or the experiments are somewhat following on in parallel with what we're doing in the clinical trials. But some of the challenge studies, we don't have perfect models to know, is it going to work? At some degree, you don't want to wait for perfection, because perfection may not be needed. You know, I don't know. I always grew up interested in biology, interested in medicine, interested in human health. Yes, I didn't become, as my parents would have hoped, an MD. I became an engineer. But that doesn't mean I don't have the same vision to help society. And as an engineer, I don't do it on an individual basis like an MD might more, but I can do it on a much larger basis by developing a vaccine that could solve problems worldwide. A life is a life, and every minute we delay is another minute of the problem still exists.